Kacey and Luna here today. I've got a couple quick things to show you on the new Tesla software update 2020.24.6.9. I give you a quick look at it over here, and I noticed a couple things that were interesting. And if you stick around to the end, I've got something pretty neat to show you. But first, let's start with the screen. On this screen, I could never get the superchargers to load up, even though the icon was there. And now, almost every time, it comes up. We're gonna navigate to Springfield. The next thing I wanted to show you is the way that it behaves on off-ramps with Navigate on autopilot. I showed you when we're going to the grocery store how it usually does a great job. However, when I showed you on this video, it didn't do well with coming back towards my apartment or getting off at that particular supercharger Springfield that I just showed you. So today, we're gonna go see if Springfield supercharger is any better. And what I noticed off camera is that coming back to my apartment, it did actually take the correct lane. So we're gonna take a look at that and I'll catch you at the end of the video. Before we get started here, I wanted to take a moment to ask you to please scroll down a little bit and see if the subscribe button is red. If it is, click on it, turn it gray. What that will do is it'll let you know when we have new content about Tesla's supercharger reviews, EV ownership. And with that, let's get to this first off-ramp and see what happens. Okay, we're coming up on our exit to the Springfield supercharger in Springfield, Virginia. Navigate on autopilot does great here. It turns on the signal, it exits. That part has been fine for quite a while. The next part is if it chooses the correct lane to get to the supercharger. Previously, it would pick the wrong lane, and going to our apartment, it would pick the wrong lane as well. But let's see now if it picks the correct lane, since that part has now been fixed on the other way. All right, that part still doing good. Now here's the part where it messes up. Well, not right here. Right here where we get to pick a lane. Let's see what it does. It needs to go left. Typically, it goes right. All right, you want to go right, huh? Yeah, no, no. Whoa, that's way wrong, buddy. Yeah, no, way wrong. Okay, so it doesn't have it right here. And we will try the apartment again to see if it was a fluke. The one thing I will say is when I first noticed it, I had actually pushed the right turn signal. So we'll see then if the signal was what did it, or if the map has enough hints for it to get in the right lane at that area. Catch you at the next scene. Okay, coming up is our exit. We're gonna make two passes. Oh, well, we might need to make two passes. The first one we're gonna do without using a turn signal to see if it chooses the correct lane. And then if that doesn't work, we'll kind of come back using the turn signal to see if it chooses the correct lane. As I said, when I discovered it, using the turn signal was how it was. So we did navigate on autopilot, selected the exit. It signaled, it's turning. I have no signal on now. Let's see how it behaves. Okay. Now it doesn't like the pedestrians, that's fine. And let's see if it does. Left lane is wrong, right lane is correct. Incorrect. Okay, so coming back, we're gonna use the turn signal and see what it does. All right, here's how the car behaves with a disabled vehicle on the side. It pulls over a little bit to the edge of the lane. Not much. All right, so here's the exit now that that got us started on this whole experiment. A couple updates ago, they started doing the right thing on this one where it gets in the right-hand lane and then it makes the actual turn. I don't have any reason to suspect that it has stopped doing that. Navigate autopilot takes the exit. And then the next thing it does is it makes the right-hand turn that we need to make up here. Yep, it signals. And it goes to turn. It doesn't always do it very cleanly. Let's see how it does now. Yeah, still not very clean, but it does the right thing still. And then navigate on autopilot exits. And then it thinks there's a stop bar that's not there. All right, So next we will try the apartment again with the turn signal activated to see if it was by fluke or if it was that my turn signal was on that chose the correct exit lane. Catch you on the flip side. Okay, so what we're going to do now is try with the signal on to see how it behaves. We did just pass two disabled vehicles on the side of the road, and we'll see how my car pulls over to the right, or to the right, to opposite of the shoulder. And so I've saved it to the Tesla cam, so we'll see if you guys can see that on the footage or not. All right, so I'll turn the right signal on now, because that's where we have to go. That truck is still here. All right, right signal is on. We'll see if it goes right like it did when I noticed this. No. Okay, so it was a fluke that it did that. So that was Smart Summon from my 2 or 3 meter selfie stick and the Kandao KuCam 8K. And if you look up here, I'll go ahead and put the 360 version of that video on there. And if you please subscribe here. And then over here and here are two videos that YouTube thinks that you'll enjoy. And we'll catch you on the flip side.